guys, welcome to my vlog. Josh, say hi.
Hello.
I'm driving up at school. He went to pick something up from Target. I'm eating an apple. I'm gonna tell you guys what I'm gonna do today. And then I'm gonna do homework, and then I'm gonna get my juice. I'm super excited. I'm gonna try another new one today. Bye. Sorry, guys. So I actually just got a new drink. I'm actually really excited to try it out. It's called the Protector. This one has turmeric, ginger, lemon, orange, and pineapple. So I just know it's gonna be tasty. At my job, they're starting to do COVID testing again, and I just, you know, natural home remedy. This lighting is bad, but yeah, I'm so excited to try it out. Okay, I'm gonna try it in the car. Bye.
Okay, here I am.
I'm normally like not a fan of paper straws because I think they're absolutely stupid, and like literally, like, everyone's like, oh, we're using like plastic straws because of the environment and like saving the turtles. And then where do you get your drink in? In a plastic cup. So are you really saving the turtles? No. Like, especially like at my, like at Starbucks, they're like a some stupid ass thing where we didn't get holiday drinks because they weren't right. Every food package that we got was wrapped in plastic. Everything sealed, whether it was like the caramel, the apple drizzle, or even like making the holiday sprinkles. Guess what it was all wrapped in? It's plastic. So you're not saving the world, you dumbass bitch. Anyway, so this is my new drink. So cute. Let me try it. First try. Oh, this is good. This is so good. My gaslight came on, but you already know I had to buy my drink. It's so good. It's like a good orange juice. Like, the one I normally get is more sweeter because it has like carrots, and you know, carrots are sweeter than turmeric and stuff, but that is very, very tasty. Okay, so my plans for today is 100% to be more positive. I'm gonna do some homework, and then I'm gonna go get my vagina wax. You guys, my biggest mistake. I've been getting, ever since we got off of lockdown, you guys, I didn't shave my whole pussy when we were during COVID. And I know you guys are probably like, Joy, what the flip? But I'm being serious. Like, I didn't shave it once. Like, obviously, like, I would trim it. But, like, there's no point because I wasn't even going anywhere. Like, I didn't go and talk to any guys. Like, it was never that serious. After COVID lockdown, I was in Maryland, and I used to get waxed at European Wax Center. Biggest mistake of my life. If you're watching this, you get waxed at European Wax Center. Literally, like, don't ever let it happen again. Basically, what happened was, I remember when I went there, and, like, it didn't get everything. And it was so fun because one of my friends was actually like, oh, I go there. And they basically want you to buy this package, this promo package, where you pay, like, over $100, $200 up front, so each one is free, like, credit. But it's absolutely bullshit because it wasn't until that, like, I started going to, like small businesses, like, an esthetician who would do it, and they would not get everything on it. So then I go on TikTok, and an ex-European Wax Center lady was like, literally, don't go there. Like, they use, like, these type of plastics that don't rip everything out. And I assure you, if you get your thing waxed at European Wax Center, stop, right? Go to a wax lady, you will see the complete difference. So I started going to this one girl. She was so dope, like, amazing. But then, obviously, like, I moved, so obviously I couldn't go. So then I found this other one. She's a sweetest, so I did a big mistake, and I shaved my pussy because someone on TikTok was like, you get these razors, they literally have a smooth finish, because it was like a male razor. And then I was like halfway through, and I was like, the pimping don't stop, like, I might as well just like finish it. Horrible. I was like in so much pain, and I literally texted my lady. I was like, this is not very slight, like, something is wrong. And I literally apologized. I was like, girl, like, I literally wouldn't do it. And she was like so nice. And so I got this dry brush, you know, I started exfoliating, which is like slay as fuck. And then, like, I had like this little full oil. So anyways, the razor bumps went away, and it was like, but anyway, so basically I'm supposed to get my pussy pierced. So I texted her, I was like, can you squeeze me in? And so I'm going after my, what time is it? I need to go, but that's my little talk. And I'm actually really excited, but I'm also on my period, so I actually have to text her. But it's like a tampon. I think what I'm gonna do, obviously I have to text her, I don't want to start her waxing, I see blood everywhere. But that's my shindig. Do not cheat on your wax lady. Do not get waxed at European Wax Center. Do not use paper straws. And do not, emphasis on do not, ever cheat on your wax lady and decide to shave or listen to a TikTok saying, because I'm just gonna lie to you. And then it was too late, because I'm not the type of person to return it after I've used it. It was like $4. I mean, it was never really that deep. But I'll catch you later. Bye bye.
Hey guys. Oh, that lighting was so bad. I just finished getting waxed. Oh my God, the lady, she's so sweet. She's so kind. Because I told you guys how I... Anyways, it was 50. I tipped her 15 because I'm on my period. So she was like really accommodating and really kind about it. And also because like I basically have to start all over because I had been waxing for 2 years and I shaved for the first time in 2 years, which is the biggest mistake of my life. But also another thing about tipping culture, I don't know when this debate began. And it's so frustrating being with people who like are like, oh, I don't tip. And it's like, okay, well, I never want to speak to you again. Because like people don't get it. And mind you, I've been working in a food service for like the past like ever since I got a job. And like it's astonishing because it's not just the sense that like, oh, this is a job that I signed up for, but it's like this is the job that I signed up for, but I did not sign up for your fat, filthy, cunty attitude. I did not sign up for all the accommodations that you're gonna do. You know what I'm saying? Because it's one thing to just go to somewhere and be like, I want steak and potatoes. And they're like, I want it like medium well done with some roasted shrimp on the side with some garlic powder, roasted. You know what I'm saying? And so like, I don't know. I like view people differently when they're like that. And like, I don't even know about the whole 10%, 20% because I don't eat out. Like the only places I go is like my sandwich and juice shop, but they don't even take tips. And then I used like In-N-Out, like you already know from the get-go, like they don't take tips. But even wherever I go, like when I used to drink Dutch and stuff, I always tip like $1 because, and I know you guys like $1, but it's like, think about it. At least 50 people go in about 30 minutes. Everyone's tipping $1, $1. That's like, you know what I'm saying? So I just feel like if everyone took the stick out of their asses and like really like smelled the coffee, they'd be like, it literally does not hurt to give an extra like $1 and stuff. Especially for the people who are like, will accommodate you. Like she literally always responds to my text, is so nice and like literally helped me because I was like, because some people are weird about it. And like, I don't know. I just feel like it doesn't hurt. You already made the distance. Finish the mile, you know what I'm saying? So I'm gonna head home. I'm gonna do some homework. I need to go on a run. First of all, I'm all out of sports bras. That's a whole nother thing. It's so hard because like my boobs like keep growing to the point where it's like I don't even know what to do. I already triple bra, like cotton bras, and I can still feel them when I run, and like I'm just like, it's just a lot's going on. And then if I wear like actual sports bras, I get like heat rash, heat burn. It's just a lot of things going on. And my mom will let me get a, like, a breast reduction. And it's so funny because, like, the thing is, in the future, I do want to have kids, but I'm not getting married. So I think I might be going to the sperm bank. But, like, your body changes. Like, everything gets bigger. Like, my tits. So there's no point in getting a reduction now. And then there's a chance. And another thing about getting a reduction is I don't know. Remember in the movie Superbad and they were talking about the girl who had a breast reduction and he goes, why would you take away God's greatest gift? He's so funny, but I'll catch up. I'll link it and then you guys will understand what I'm saying, but I'm hey guys. That. Okay, snack time. I'm eating some carrots and hummus. You guys, I literally love hummus. It's so yummy. And there's so many fun different flavors. Like, they're so fun. They're like little potato chips like this. So yummy. Yeah, and I'm gonna eat some cuties and boiled eggs. You guys are probably wondering, okay, none of you guys are wondering, I actually literally have nothing to say. I'm gonna disassociate and watch some Vampire Diaries and just escape to my dream reality. So tired. I don't know why I'm so tired. Oh yeah, because my ear, you guys, it's been killing me. I need to go take a dookie. I had to take a big old dookie, but before I got waxed, but like I was like, nah, I'm away. Okay, I'm gonna actually I'm not taking a dookie because girls don't poop. What was I gonna do?